I've always been curious to know what primer really is the best for painting laminate furniture, and if you can really get away without sanding before priming. So, this week I put 4 different primers through a durability and bonding test against this laminate desktop. Then, I took it a step further by testing each primer on sanded laminate and not sanded laminate. And then, to top it off, I tested chalk paint versus latex paint on each sample. Okay, so first I cleaned the laminate with crud cutter to remove all of the dust and any grease or oil from the surface. No matter what, cleaning with some sort of degreaser cleaner before painting will always make the paint stick better. I personally love and use the original crud cutter for all of my furniture flips, but a bucket of hot soapy water with Dawn dish soap cuts through grease and grime too. Then I sanded half of the laminate top with my favorite 3M 220 grit sandpaper. I chose half of the laminate top that had the old nail polish on it so I could sand that off. And honestly, if nothing else, that's one major benefit to sanding furniture before painting. If I left the nail polish on there and I just painted over it, there's a very good chance that you would be able to see the little nail polish spots after I painted everything. Same goes for scratches or anything else that is on top of or in the surface of the furniture. Sometimes a good sanding is really necessary to get rid of those. I sanded just enough to dull down the shine in the laminate and to remove the nail polish. The point of sanding is to give the paint or primer something to hold on to. So for a little comparison, just like how it's hard for us to get a really good grip on something that is really slick, it's hard for paint to get a good grip on slick laminate. And then I left the other half of the laminate untouched, so it was only cleaned with a crud cutter but not touched with sandpaper at all. You can see the difference here. On the left, it's less shiny, and that's where I sanded, and on the right, it's nice and shiny, and that's where I didn't sand. Then I taped off the laminate into sections. I taped it right down in the middle, right on the line of sanding and not sanding. Then I taped the 2 sections into 5 of their own sections. The first section was for no primer, the next section was for the bin shellac base primer, and the next section for clear shellac. Then the next section was for the Bullseye 123 primer tinted gray, and the last section was for Country Chic Paint's clear bonding primer. I know there are so many different other primers out there, but I just really did not have space for everything, and these were the top 4 that I had on hand. First up was the clear shellac primer because I use it in a spray can. So I covered all the other sections so I wouldn't get shellac on them, and then I sprayed the clear shellac in the sanded section and the not sanded section. I wanted to test the white tinted shellac versus the clear shellac because I love distressing furniture and showing some wood on the edges and details. But if you use the white tinted primer, you'll see the white in between the paint and the wood, and that kind of ruins the look for me. So I would love for the clear shellac to be a winner in this test. Next up was the water-based Bullseye 123 gray tinted primer. I love the idea of using water-based primer because I hate the fumes of shellac or oil-based primers. I love to be able to work indoors when I want to and not have to feel like I have to work outdoors, especially when it's the dead of winter. The can boasts that this primer can stick to all surfaces without sanding, and I've honestly never believed it. But since the can says it sticks, I wanted to test it out against all the other options, just to see. Then I painted on Country Chic Paint's clear bonding primer that is made for applications like this. It's water-based and it's clear, so it has 2 of my favorite things going for it. No harsh fumes, and I can distress the paint on top of it for a farmhouse style finish. The problem though is that it's not as easy to grab at a local hardware store, and it doesn't come in a spray can for easy spray application, and I love to spray things instead of brush things on. But I'm really curious to see how it fares against the competition. I've used it in the past, and I thought it worked pretty well. Last but not least, I brushed on the bin shellac based primer that is usually a top recommendation when you're painting laminate furniture. It's easy to get at your local hardware store and it comes in the spray can or the containers, just like the clear shellac and the Bullseye 123 primer. It's shellac based like the clear shellac I sprayed on, and it definitely has fumes. But it's tinted white, or you can tint it closer to the paint color you like the gray 123 primer. After 1 coat, I let all of the primers dry for the recommended time. The binge shellac primer can be painted in 45 minutes, the clear shellac and the 123 gray primer in 1 hour, and the country chic paint primer needs 12 hours to dry before painting over it. So after an hour, I painted a coat of some of the latex that I had on hand and a coat of my favorite chalk paint, country chic paint, on all of the sections except for the country chic paint bonding primer that needed to dry overnight. The next day, I ended up with a total of 2 coats of latex paint and chalk paint on all of the sections. And then, since it was Saturday and I don't work on Sunday, I let the paint all dry until Monday afternoon, which gave it all time to dry for at least 24 hours plus more. Typically, when you do a scratch test to make sure the paint is going to stick, it's recommended to let your paint dry for at least 24 hours before seeing if it will stick or not. I was so excited when I was able to start the scratch test on Monday. So first up, I just used my fingernail to try to scratch off the paint. I started with the not sanded with no primer section. Just like I suspected, the latex paint and the chalk paint came off pretty easily with just my fingernail. So I moved on to the sanded section with no primer, and it came off pretty easily too, but not quite as easily as the section where I hadn't sanded. The chalk paint was a little bit harder to scratch off than the latex paint was to scratch off too. So there is definitely some extra bonding going on with the chalk paint versus the latex paint. Then I tried scratching off the binge shellac base primer. I first just tried scratching off the primer where I hadn't painted over it, and both sections, the sanded and not sanded, did not budge where I just put 1 coat of primer on. And in both the sanded and the not sanded sections of the binge shellac, the latex paint stuck for a scratch or two, but then it scratched away from the primer. The chalk paint, though, held up great on both, and I could not get it to scratch off the binge shellac primer at all. The clear shellac base primer sections were pretty similar, with the latex paint scratching off of the primer just a little tiny bit, no matter if it was sanded or not before priming. But the chalk paint hung onto the clear shellac for dear life when I tried to scratch it off. And then at this point, both of my cameras had issues catching the test, so the footage you see now is me going back to show you how the rest of the primer stood against the scratch test. When I moved to the Bullseye 123 gray primer, I first tried scratching at just the primer just to see how well it stuck. And right off the bat, it scratched off of the not sanded section. So of course, the latex paint scratched off easily too, but somehow the chalk paint still held on. On the sanded side of the gray tinted primer, when I just scratched the primer stuck pretty well. The latex paint, though, did not stick to the primer very well, but once again, the chalk paint held on. Finally, I got to the Country Chic Paint Clear Primer. The sanded and the not sanded side gave pretty similar results, with the sanded side coming out on top just by a little bit. The latex paint scratched off a little bit, and even the chalk paint scratched off the little tiniest bit. Just for fun and good measure, I also busted out my metal paint scraper just to give each paint and primer section one last chance. Obviously, you're not going to take a metal paint scraper to your furniture while you're using it, but there is definitely no guarantee that a kid might do something similar. Amazingly enough, though, the results were pretty much the same with the scraper as they were my fingernail. You can see some gray left behind, and that's just some silver left from the metal. The scraper definitely scratched through the latex paint a lot more than it ever scratched through the chalk paint. Honestly, I was pretty surprised by the results. I am all about sanding before priming and painting just to make sure that your paint sticks. And I still think that that is the best advice. But I've got to say, in this case, the shellac-based primers had excellent adhesion, whether the laminate was sanded before or not. I'll still be sanding before priming with them, especially because I sell my furniture. But if you're looking to get the job done a little bit quicker, painting laminate without sanding is totally possible with a shellac-based primer beforehand. I'm also honestly shocked that the 123 gray tinted primer held up so well on the sanded side. and that the latex paint overall wasn't as good as the chalk paint. I mean, I know that chalk paint has better adhesion, but I thought that over primer, it would have pretty similar adhesion. I definitely was not surprised at all that the no primer at all and the 123 gray primer without sanding didn't hold up at all. And even though the Country Chic Paint clear primer chipped just a little tiny bit, I'm still really impressed with it, especially since it's a water-based product that probably needs just a little bit more time to cure before it can be more durable. So in the end, I think you just have to weigh your options. The best overall winners for the scratch test was the Bin Shellac Base Primer and the Clear Shellac Primer, both with and without sanding. The Bullseye 123 Primer Tinted Gray and the Country Chic Paint Bonding Primer, both sanded before priming, worked great as well. I think that if you let the 123 Primer and the Country Chic Paint Primer cure for a little longer, the results would be the same as the shellac primers. On one hand, you have your quick shellac-based primers that have a good amount of fumes, but you don't have to sand before using them. On the other hand, you have the water-based primers that take a little bit longer to cure into highly durable primers, and you really need to sand them before using them, but they have very little to no fumes to worry about. If you thought this video was helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe for more. I'd love to hear your experiences with these and other primers on laminate furniture.